Hey guys, Seven WWE Rocks here, and I'm here to do my WWE 2016 Hell in a Cell predictions. It is, of course, this Sunday, October 30th, 2016. 8 matches on the card. Am I gonna watch it? No, probably not. Unless I hear the women's Hell in a Cell is, like, really crazy. Because that's really, like, all I honestly care about. I feel like everything's gonna be, like, everyone's gonna retain their titles and whatnot. I mean, I'm gonna get my predictions, but I think that women's Hell in a Cell match is the only one that really interests me, just because, you know, it's the first time ever in a WWE, you know, ring. I'm really excited for it. I'll probably watch it if I hear it's amazing. If I hear it's not that great, then, you know. But let's get right into these predictions. Kicking us off with the pre-show, we got in a cruiserweight tag match, Cedric Alexander, Lince Dorado, and Sin Cara versus Tony Nese, Drew Gulak, and Aria Davari. Just gotta say, these six guys, that's a really talented group, so I'm glad they're getting this, you know, exposure, even if it's just the pre-show. I'm pretty happy for these guys. I think they're all really, really talented, and I wanna say the good guys win, Cedric, Lince, and Sin Cara, but, you know, it seems like they might go places with Tony Nese. I really like Drew Gulak, and I really wish they would push him, like, not even as a cruiserweight guy. I could see him, like, actually fighting people on the main roster that, you know, aren't in the cruiserweights. But I'm going to go with the good guy team, Cedric Alexander, Lince Dorado, and Sin Cara. So on the actual card, Enzo and Big Cass versus Gallows and Anderson. Honestly, I really don't care who wins, because I honestly think it's going to do nothing for either team. It's not like if one wins, they're going to, you know, go so far. I'm gonna say Gallows and Anderson. I really hope they get a win, because I like Enzo and Big Cass. I really do. I thought when Enzo did the promo thing without a mic, when he was just, you know, using like invisible mic, I thought that was awesome. But I think it's so sad that Gallows and Anderson are losing this easily to, like, every match. So I think it really sucks, but I think Gallows and Anderson definitely should win this match. Maybe get a tag title run. I think they should have took them off New Day. That's what I'm saying. Bayley versus Dana Brooke. For the love of God, please end this. It's like the tag teams and the women. If they're not in the title picture, they're versing the same exact people. Enzo and Big Cass has been doing this whole thing with Gallows and Anderson. Bayley and Dana Brooke have versed each other like 50 different times. It was an arm wrestling match. I mean, please, for the love of God, just end it. That's my prediction. Please, for the love of God, end it. I'm gonna go with Bayley to win it. Hopefully Bayley wins and Dana Brooke goes on feuding with Charlotte. That's really all I think we should care about. New Day defending their tag titles against Cesaro and Sheamus. We saw this match on Raw, which is like, what's the point? But since Cesaro and Sheamus actually won on Raw, I'm going to say New Day wins. But because I don't see them losing twice. And I don't know what they're doing with Cesaro and Sheamus. Like, if they do lose, like, do they go back to feuding with each other? Do they stick a tag team? Do they win the tag titles and that's why they stick as a tag team? I don't know. But we'll see. I just say New Day retains. I kind of do want someone to take it off New Day, the tag titles. TJ Perkins versus Brian Kendrick for the Cruiserweight Championship. So, it's kind of weird because, well, not weird. It's bad booking. Brian Kendrick, his whole thing in the Cruiserweight Classic, this is my last shot. I have to win it or I'm done. He loses. Then he gets a chance at Raw. And he gets to fight TJ Perkins for the Cruiserweight Championship. Again, this is my last chance. I need to win the title. He loses. Gets another. He gets a rematch against TJ Perkins even though he lost. So, and he's saying, this is my last shot. I need to win. So I don't really, like, understand why they keep doing this. I mean, obviously it's not his last shot. I'm going to say Brian Kendrick wins, because if he does lose, I think there's nothing left for him to do, really, just because how they've been booking him. But I'm going to say Kendrick actually wins it. He's asking TJ Perkins to lose the match on purpose. We'll see what happens. I don't think that's going to happen, but I think Brian Kendrick will cheat to win or something. Hell in a Cell match, Rusev versus Roman Reigns, the start of a triple main event, whatever that means. Roman Reigns retains the United States Championship. Kevin Owens versus Seth Rollins for the Universal title in a Hell in a Cell match. Kevin Owens retains. I think all we really care about is Kevin Owens versus Chris Jericho. And fingers crossed, I hope that happens at Survivor Series. I really do. And what I think is the main event, this is why I said it last, Charlotte versus Sasha Banks for the women's title in a Hell in a Cell match. I think it should be the main event just because this is the first time it's ever happened in the history of the WWE. Not the booking so far, because I think the booking's been really rough. Mick Foley, that promo, oh my gosh, it felt so forced. I made a whole video about it, but I'm going to say Sasha Banks retains her title, which kind of makes me think, like, I have everyone retaining their titles except in the Hell in a Cell matches. So that makes me think maybe I'll be wrong on one of them. But I'm going to say Sasha Banks retains it, and it's a good match. I really hope it is. So thanks so much for watching. Like, comment, subscribe, all the good stuff. Follow me on Twitter at 7WWRocks. Please, in the comment section down below, let me know your predictions as well. I'd love to hear them. Let me know if you're going to watch the show. Let me know if you're interested about whatever match. I'd love to hear it. And just, I hope you enjoy the start of your weekend. Hopefully, if everything goes planned, I should have some interesting videos tomorrow and Sunday. So, thank you so much for watching. And as always, have a great day.